So how much? That's important. So 10 gram, 20 gram is more than enough. So completely going on a zero fat diet for a very long duration, in any way, it's going to give you the hormone deficiency, and which itself is a defense mechanism. Raw material is the same. It's the same raw material, cholesterol. Cholesterol is a raw material for your estrogen, progesterone, testosterone, DHEA, cortisol, aldosterone. So when you are dieting, like dieting, intense dieting when you are doing, which is required when you have to lose weight. So what you are doing is you are limiting your resources. So the resources will go to the pathway which cannot be compromised. Means the life-saving pathway. And the life-saving pathways are the cortisol and the aldosterone pathway, and not the testosterone pathway. So everything is diverted to that side. So therefore you are going to have lack of testo and estrogen. That is one part. How the defense mechanism is causing the plateau. Because nature does not want you to lose weight. So here I will take the obesity segment. Chota sa leta hu. Nature ye nahi chahta ki aap wazan kam kare. Wo to mother nature hai na. Koi maa nahi chahti ki uska bachcha negative mein jaye. Aur hamare body ke andar system jitne bhi hain, wo sab preservation ke hain. Or only in starvation or fasting or whenever there is a lack of energy, lack of supply of energy, then only they will break and give. It's like a saving bank and a fixed deposit type of a thing. So when we are crash dieting and we are losing weight, at that time we are losing the, we have to, one is the pathway is going towards the life saving pathway of cortisol. Second is nature wants somehow our energy expenditure should also go down. Intake is low, so expenditure should also be low, so the balance is created and we are not losing any weight. And the best way to decrease the energy outcome or energy expenditure is to decrease the physical activity. And the best way to decrease the physical activity by the nature is, first is your neurotransmitter change, so you are not motivated for physical activity like exercise or anything. Second is the leisure activities.
Sorry?
Leisure. Yeah. The sexuality going to be affected. And how this will be affected is by decreasing your testo, estrogen, progesterone. And then in a woman, the next step is amenorrhea. Amenorrhea of starvation. So nature is trying two things over here. And also comes the role of thyroid here, somewhere. And nature, when in a woman, causing amenorrhea is solving two purposes. One, because of the less energy supply, you are not fit for fertility. So nature is trying to make you, at that point of time, it's an emergency situation, you know, don't do anything. Second is, the loss of iron in the blood, in your menstrual blood. Somewhere nature will try to preserve, they'll preserve that. So doing fasting, amenorrhea, infertility, all is happening through what? Through the endocrine pathway, neuroendocrine pathway. Now the question is, what to do in this scenario? Answer is simple. What is the demand? If losing weight is giving you more benefit than all these things, let it happen. You don't have to correct them at that point of time. You got it? Let them happen till the extent where you can reverse it as a doctor. So let the weight go down, be more aggressive, let more go down, doesn't matter, there is a demotivation, there is amenorrhea, there is depression, say feeling low, there is irritability, doesn't matter, we doctors are there to take care of you. But as soon as you reach to your weight, now we are going to reverse it. You got it? And here comes the role of supplementation of HRT or supplementation of calories back and then maintain them. So this is what we are going to talk in the obesity segment. The relationship of losing weight and